Hi everyone, we are going to see the topic CSMA, that is Career Science Multiple Access. So multiple access, the method which is implemented in computer network when multiple stations are connected in a network and want to transmit a signal through the medium, transmitting medium, and to avoid collision, so when multiple stations are transmitting a signal through the common medium, there may be collision, and how do we avoid? So multiple access and to avoid collision. So we are going to see, first we will see what is carrier sense multiple access, then after that we will see the technique collision detection. So the multiple access method, carrier sense, when these multiple stations, like let us take the station A, B, C and D are accessing the channel medium and carrier sense, the condition in this methodology that station has to first check the transmission medium is busy or not. When the station A wants to transmit its signal, the packet, check the medium is busy or not. So if the medium is busy, it will wait, otherwise the signal which is sent by A will have a collision with another signal in the transmission medium. So if the medium is busy, the station A has to wait until the medium gets idle. So the concept here is sense before transmit. So carrier sense, it is sensing the carrier medium whether it is busy or idle. If it is idle, then access the medium. So in this method, the possibility of collision can be reduced, but cannot be eliminated. We cannot completely eliminate the collision. And one important point to be considered here is when station A wants to transmit a signal, it can send only, it can sense only the link at this point, and the station A will not be able to check whether all this medium, the throughout the medium, the channel is busy or not. So when it checks the point here, and if it seems that the channel is free at this time and this place, then immediately A will start transmitting its signal. So the problem here is, in case a station B also checking the point at this place, and it is checking the transmission medium at this place, at the same time if station A and station B, both the stations are checking the channel medium, and both the station will not be able to observe the complete transmission medium. If it is free, it starts transmitting the signal, and when B checks the channel, it seems it is free, so it will also start transmitting the signal. After some time, there is a collision with the signal transmitted by station A and the signal transmitted by B. So the station A can sense only this point at a time when B also is sensing the medium, whether the medium is busy or not. There is no any propagation of signal, so A will find the medium is idle and B also finds the medium is idle. So at the same time, A and B will start transmitting its signal. So A will transmit the signal and B also transmitting its signal. But what happens after some time, there is a collision between both the signals transmitted by station A and transmitted by station B. And when this collision, when the signal from B reaching the point near the A station, the A will get to know the collision, there is a collision. And when the collision signal reaches the point near the station B, and that time only station B will get to know there is a collision. And if there is a collision, then station A has to retransmit the copy of the signal once again, and the same way B also has to retransmit the signal. So how to get to know the collision with the frame transmitted by station A? There are procedures we need to follow that will be discussed in CSMA-CD, CSMA collision detection. So what is vulnerable time? Generally, the propagation delay is an important parameter we need to consider when we transmit a signal through the medium and when multiple stations are accessing the medium. So let's say the station A started sending its frame. So the first byte of the frame started at time T1, and the first byte takes time to reach the destination here at this point. The time taken by the last byte of the frame to reach its destination is propagation time. So when the first byte of a frame from station A transmitted, B will get to know after some time. If the time taken to reach from A to B is 3 milliseconds, then after 3 milliseconds only the station B will be able to find the channel is actually busy, because the first byte will take 3 milliseconds to reach, and if the byte takes time to reach from station B to station C are 4 milliseconds, and when the frame started transmitted from station A after 7 milliseconds only, C will understand that the channel is busy. So the propagation time is the main consideration when we talk about the collision in the transmission medium between the signals transmitted from different channels. So the vulnerable time for the CSMA is actually propagation time. In CSMA, three methods are actually followed when the stations want to transmit a signal through the medium. So the station one, check the medium, transmission medium, whether the medium is busy or not. If it is busy, it has to wait, either wait, otherwise there will be a collision after sending the signal. So the first method is actually one persistent. One persistent means at a time when the station checking the medium, and in case if the station is transmitting a packet when the channel is busy, it gets collided. So next one, non-persistent. Non-persistent means, so the station is actually first checking the medium is busy or not. If the medium is busy, and it will wait for the time, and the station keep sensing the channel until it gets idle, it gets free. So when the channel becomes idle, it starts sending a data. So the third method is P persistent. P persistent means it follows a slot, which is the medium slot duration. It actually checks the slot. If the channel slot is greater than or equal to propagation delay, it starts transmitting the data. Otherwise, it will wait for a time. So overall, what is CSMA? Carrier sends multiple access. So multiple stations are accessing this channel medium, but the condition is the channel has to check whether the medium is busy or not, it is idle or not. If any carrier signal is propagated through the medium, then the carrier sends is to be done by the station which wants to transmit its signal. And if it is free, then transmitting the signal, or it has to wait until the medium gets idle. And for the point collision, the propagation time is an important factor, and how to avoid the collision, we go for the method called CSMACD. CSMACD means carrier sends multiple access collision detection. Normally in CSMA, there is no procedure to find the collision. So after the packet transmitted from the station A, when it is propagating through the medium, if the last byte of the frame left the station A, and station will not have the touch with the frame, and in case during the transmission, the transmitted frame from station A may get collided with from the frame by another station, and A will not have the knowledge of the collision happened. So what is the way to detect the collision of a transmitted signal? In case if there is any collision, how to detect? So there is a procedure. So we need to consider some point. As we have seen already, the propagation delay, TP is the notation for propagation delay. Previously we have seen the point, the propagation time is an important factor when we talk about collision. So what happens in CSMACD method? The station is not only checking the medium is free or idle, it also monitors the medium after it sends the packets. So for example, let us take the propagation time of the medium from station A to station C is 6 milliseconds. So at time T1, at 1 millisecond, the frame started from the station A, the first byte of the information started transmitting from station A at a time T1, so it is actually propagating through the medium. And let's say the station C also wants to send its packet, and at 2 millisecond it is checking whether the medium is idle or busy. So obviously at 2 milliseconds, the medium, the C will find the medium is actually idle, it is not busy. And at 2 milliseconds, station C, the first byte from station C starts traveling in both the side, here in both right side and left side. So at 2 milliseconds, the frame at 2 milliseconds, the first byte from station A is reached here. So at 4 milliseconds, what happens? There is a collision between the first byte of the information started from A and the first byte of the information started from station C. So at this time, both the station will not be able to detect the collision happened between the packets transmitted from station A and C. When the time is 6 milliseconds, then only the station C will understand there is a collision and it stops transmitting the signal. It has to, and the station C will retransmit the signal when the channel becomes idle. So how to monitor a collision in a transmission medium after information the signal is transmitted from the station? So here we need to consider the size of the frame. To monitor the collision in a channel medium after a frame transmitted, the size of the frame is to be considered. So the size of the frame should be TT is nothing but the transmission delay, that is actually L divided by B. L is the number of bits, the frame size, and divided by bandwidth, the bandwidth of the medium. And L should be greater than or equal to 2 into TP into B. So what is TP? Why it is 2 into TP? Because let's say the propagation time from the station A to station D is 8 milliseconds, and if the channel is idle, and that is the channel is free, A will find the channel is free, and at 1 millisecond it starts sending the packet. And when it reaches, for example, at 7.5 milliseconds, the D may check the medium and it wants to transmit a signal. Obviously the medium will be free at 7.5 milliseconds, and if the station D also transmitting at 7.5 milliseconds, what happens after 0.5 milliseconds? There is a collision and D wants to transmit a packet from station D to station A. So after the collision happened, it will take another 7.5 milliseconds to reach station A. So totally after 8 milliseconds only, the station A will understand there is a collision. And if the transmission delay is greater than or equal to 16 milliseconds, so obviously after the frame transmitted from station A, the last byte from the frame is still available because the size is actually greater than or equal to 2 into B. And if there is a collision, because it is continuously monitoring based on this condition, the station will be able to find it and retransmit the packet once again. So let us take one example here. The example given is the network using CSMACD. CSMACD means the channel is actually monitored by station even after sending. Initially station is checking the medium is busy or not, and if the channel is free, it starts sending the data. And to monitor the medium, the condition is actually the frame. The transmission delay should be greater than or equal to 2 into TP, propagation delay. So here the question is, the network using this technique has a bandwidth of 10 megabits per second. So bandwidth is given, that is 10 megabits per second. If the maximum propagation time here is 25.6 microseconds, so TP is 25.6 microseconds, then what is the minimum size of the frame? So minimum size of the frame we use to monitor the channel medium after sending a packet to identify whether the packet, whether there is a collision with the packet transmitted or not. So the condition to monitor the minimum, the condition for the minimum size of the frame is T suffix FR. FR is nothing but the frame. T suffix FR is equal to 2 into T suffix P, TP. So we have propagation time and transmission delay is found 51 microsecond. So transmission delay is nothing but L divided by B, bandwidth. L is the size of the frame, and bandwidth is given as 10 megabits per second. And after substituting, we are finding the size of the frame should be 512 bits. are 64 bytes. So from this lecture, we have understood these carrier sends multiple access, that multiple stations are accessing the channel media, but the condition here is the station has to check whether the medium is busy or not. If the medium is idle, then only the station will start transmitting its frame. But after sending the frame, the station wants to monitor the channel medium because it has to detect if there is any collision with the data transmitted by the station. So for this monitoring purpose, we go with a condition called, that is, a transmission delay should be greater than or equal to 2 into TP. Thank you.